all my frailties and with all my faults, I did not want them to turn out to be like I thought and felt their dad was. So all of my children, and including my little sisters, are dynamos, not only in this world, in the secular world, but also in Christ, in loving Christ. And I think that's the most important thing that we can do, because there is an urgency that we face today in this country where right is no longer considered right, and wrong is now considered to be the new right. Amen. We don't care about Jesus or about the Word of God. We allow people to determine what type of people we're going to be. They determine our marriages. They tell us that the Bible is antiquated, and that there is no love in the Bible, that it is a white man's book, as they said in Sunday school, where they were talking about. But you know what? God made everybody. And let me tell you something. God is a spirit. And he said we should worship him in spirit and in truth. Not only did he create the black man, but he created the white man. He said red, yellow, black, or white. You may be polka dot, you may be plaid, but all is precious in his sight. Amen. Amen. I'm going to share this with you as well. Preaching, I love after it's over. When I'm getting ready to do it, I am a wretched mess. You hear me? I mean, I want to throw up. My stomach turns inside out. I got to stand up here and look at these people, and you got to look at me, and I'm saying, Lord, have mercy, if only they knew. You know, sometimes I want to say to Pastor Earl, he called me Thursday. I really called him and tell him, hey, they don't pay you enough. I called him Saturday. I'm going to tell him, you know, Pastor, they don't pay you enough because you got to. And Derek Fox and all these ministers would attest to this. You got to turn that book over. You got to wrestle with that spirit, because it's not supposed to be our word, but God's word. That's what we're supposed to be sharing with you today. Now, I want to go with you I want you to go with me in the book of John. Hello? Now, y'all laughing at me. I hope y'all laughing with me. What is it? I have spaces as fast now. In the book of John, in fact, the seventh chapter of the ninth chapter leading from the first verse to the seventh chapter of John. And John is a unique book in that of all the four Gospels, John is considered to stand by itself. Matthew, Mark, and Luke are considered synoptic. They tell the same story. But John tries to point to the deity of Christ. He's trying to point at the Godship of God. That's why he starts by saying, in the beginning, God was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word became flesh, and the Word spoke among men. You may be seated, ushers. I'm getting started now. I'm not going to be here. So he starts with that the Word was made flesh, and that became God, Jesus, and the Word dwelled among men. I'm in the book. I'm paraphrasing. Oh, okay. What you looking at? What you telling me? Huh? Oh, okay. Y'all want me to hurry up and sit down? Huh? Huh? Oh, they got, okay. Hey. So in the book of John, John shows us at least, it goes over seven of the of miracles of Jesus Christ that's all pointed to the deity of Jesus Christ. One talks about when he talks when he turns water to wine. Well, that's points to him being over life, and that he is the inventor. I'm gonna try and find my notes here real quick, but I'm hoping that I need them. The others lead to different miracles, like when he had the 5,000, when he fed the 5,000, that talked about him showing him being the bread of life. And the sixth, where he talks here in John about the about healing the blind man that had been blind from his youth, that speaks to him being the light of the world. And I want to speak to you today on that. And in this book, it starts by saying this in verse 9. It says, and Jesus passed by, and he saw a man which was blind from his birth. And his disciples asked him, saying, Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? Jesus answered and said, neither this man has sinned, but the works of God shall be made manifest in him. I must work the works of him that sent me while it is day, for the night cometh when no man can work. He said, while I'm in the world, I am the light of the world. And he sped down and he grabbed some dirt from the ground and he spat on it and he anointed the man's eyes with the mud and he told him to go and wash in the pool of Siloam, which means sent. And the man went and he came back seeing. Can we pray? Oh, Father God, we do thank you, Heavenly Father, for this just opportunity to break the bread of life with your people. Father God, we do not look on this as not a serious matter. For we know, Heavenly Father, that every word of your mouth that comes from this book, Lord, is precious in your sight. And that is given to us that we may live a better and perfect life. It is power. It is salvation. It is life. Bless us. Remove us. Use us. In the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. Amen. You know, I was with one of my boys, and I was sitting with Omar, Dr. O, and there was a lot of professional young men around them. One was an ophthalmologist. He was an eye specialist. And he had begun to talk about things that they had done and how God had blessed them to be a blessing to others. And he talked about how an elderly gentleman had come to him and he had never seen a flower for a long, long time. He had never seen a sunrise or sunset. He had never even seen the faces of his spouse nor his children. And that young man, he just filled my heart with joy as he was talking about how God had used his training to give that sight to that old man. You know, really, we have the same privilege, us as Christians. We have this, the privilege of giving sight to the blind. For we surely live in a blind, dark, sin, sick world. And God has given us that similar privilege for us to do just that. We come to church, and our church is like dynamite. Every one of us, our choir that sings, there's sincerity, there's joy, there's Holy Spirit in this house. And then the benediction has been said, and we walk out of those doors, and that's when church really begins. Because you are what the world don't see. Those that are not reading the Bible, guess what? They're reading you. And they're reading me. So we are the light. Jesus was passing by, and the disciples, of course, they saw a man who had been blind. And you know, we always think that pain, death, health is sometimes, or we feel that it's always associated with something bad. If in this world, when you look around and you look at people, you think that they're being blessed because of the amount of money that they have or how much is in their bank account. We equate that with a blessing. But you know, Jesus wasn't looking at them, and thank God for Jesus. And I know I have a witness of all of you right here. But especially, I know of Sister Jackson, and I listened to the sermons and stuff that the brother was preaching. It says that you don't know what God has done for us. You don't know how, where we come from. You don't know how we have fallen and how God has lifted us up. You know, I never saw Jesus, and I went to church all of my life. I was baptized in New Hope from the time I was 9 years old, and I attended church, but I never really saw Christ until I was lying flat on my back. Sometimes God has allowed us to lie on our back before we can see Jesus. Sometimes we think that because of our health and because of our strength and because of our youth that we are doing it all, but really we are not. I must work the works of him that sent me while it is day, for the night cometh when no man can work. Now, isn't that interesting that Jesus would say something like that? He says that he has only a brief time on this earth in order to do work for God. And so do we. You know, all things come to an end. You know, the sun lives and exists for, in the solar system, for billions of years. But it dies. The trees, they live for thousands of years. But it dies. Death is the end of all things to this world. It terminates all earthly relations. It ends all plans. It severs all ties. It stops all toils. It dislodges all possessions. It is the common denominator. We all have a rendezvous with death. Every step you step into, or every step you step out of, death steps in. From the cradle to the grave. The moment you're born, you're on your way to death. We have but a little time. It seems long when we start out, but it's really a little time. God says to the young, remember now thy creator in the days of thy youth, when the evil days come not. He says to the old, he says, whosoever will call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. He says to us that's in between that now is the time of salvation. The day you hear my voice, harden not your heart. We're not sure what tomorrow is going to bring. Life is so short. Gone tomorrow. Was here yesterday. Look at all around us at New Hope. Remember the faces that have left here. There's an urgency of now. What are you doing now? You're just little dynamos. Did you know that? Did you know that? God has created you as dynamite. You make the difference in your household. Wherever you go, you make a difference. Light can't stand darkness. So don't feel bad when you are uncomfortable, because light can't stand darkness. Light will disperse the dark. And that's what you do. You are the light of this world. Oh, yes. Yes. That's what Jesus said in this story. He says that as long as I'm in the world, I am the light of the world. He said to you and me that let your light, so shine that men may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. It's not to glorify you, it's to glorify Him. You are light. You ought to look at each other and give each other a high five and say, I'm light. You hear me? I'm dynamite. You hear me? I'll make a difference. Oh, yes. I'll make the difference. I'm like E.F. Hutton. When I talk, everybody listens. Heaven listens. Yeah. You know, what's it? Actually, why you be laughing? I can't help it sometimes. Just the word just gets so good in me. It just tickles me sometimes because it's just so simple. It is just so simple. God. You know, sometimes the pastor preached about God sometimes let bad things happen to good people. Every closed door does not mean that that's going to be a no, because God didn't open the window. All circumstances may seem to be bad, But the word says that all things work together for who's good? Who good? Our good. According to his righteousness and glory. Woo! You talking about wanting to shout? That's something to shout. You know, I've never been so happy in all my life after I got to be old and sick. You know, I played football, and it was calling me demon because I knocked down things. I paid off houses at 33, Heritage Hill home, and I was 33 years old when it was paid off. I've lost houses. I've gained things, but through it all, if it wasn't for the goodness of Jesus, where would we be? Oh, yeah, there ain't no reason in the world for us not to be happy. That's why I come with a smile on my face. You know, that's why I said, joy is mine. Huh? Oh, yes, it is. Oh, we got something to share with people. It's our life. People are looking at us. We are the light. We're important folk in here. Every one of you. Important. Somebody. Don't have to look down on me. And I don't have to look up except for to Jesus. Why? I'm somebody. God made me. When God made you, guess what? He broke the mold. I got two sisters and they're twins. But guess what? Barbara is different than Bunny. They look alike. They talk alike. They act alike. But they're different. Mrs. Jennings and Mrs. Likely, when I was a little kid, I never could tell them apart as a little boy. They looked alike. They walked alike. They talked alike. They dressed alike. But they're different. God broke the mold when he made you. There's nobody else on this earth. That's you. Somebody might look like you. They may sound like you. They may walk like you. But you're you. When we pray, guess what? He hears you. When we sing as a choir. But guess what? He hears you. Woo! You talking about somebody. You talking about being somebody. We're somebody. And we need to act like it and show it. We need to be a blessing because God has blessed us. He is a blessing to us. Let me tell you, and I'm bringing this to a close. Y'all probably tired of me anyway. What we have to realize is that we are all ambassadors of God. We are Christ's ambassadors. We are all co-workers with God. The Bible tells us, should ask my friend Gene, because he tells you stay right there in the Bible. But Gene Likely, but we're all co-laborers with God. We're his mouthpiece, not just the minister, trustees, deacons, but you. You determine what your children is going to be. They may not start off the way you want them to start off. They may fall behind. They may do some things that you're not proud of. But if you've done your job, God will bring them through. Don't you worry. Don't you spend your last breath. I know we worry about our kids. But just remember, it's in the hands of God. Just like you was. Just like you are. Let me show you the lesson. This is what the lesson was really. If I guess I digress a little. This is what the lesson is about. First of all, it's about faith, being obedient to God. Faith without works is dead. Faith where there's no obedience is not faith at all. It's just talk. It's just a loud noise. But here's what happened. Jesus told this man, he said that, go to the pool of Siloam and be and anoint your eyes or wash in that pool. And by faith, he left and he went to the pool. He didn't go to his mother's house. He didn't stop by the lake. He went to the pool of Siloam. And guess what? The Bible says he come seeing. He come back and he could see. Oh, you ought to read that whole chapter right there of all the things he went through after just being saved by Jesus. All the things that we also go through as well. So, the moral of this is, you have one life. We're not going to get out of this alive. Why not use it for Jesus? Why are you wished? Why are you washed and receive your sight today? Why don't you give it to somebody else? Why don't you share it? Today is your day. Every day is your day. Every day is an opportunity to be used of God. You don't have to preach it. Just live it. And God will be used of you. The urgency is now. Amen. Amen. Did you want to get? Want to give the call to worship the doors of the church, and I'm going to say that I know we sounds like a cliche, but the doors of the church is open. If you have not received your Lord as Jesus Christ as the Savior of your life, guess what? You are missing out on a good life. I don't have any money. A lot of us don't have any money, but God provides. If you want to be happy for the rest of your life, choose Jesus. Oh, I'm not saying that you're not going to have some problems, because you will. Once you accept Jesus as your personal Savior, that's when the trouble began. But guess what? You have a Savior. You have someone that stands against the tides of the world. You have someone to lean on in times of trouble. Are you willing to accept him today? Now is the time. Now is the hour. Now is the day. Why are you waiting? What are you waiting on? Times are not going to get any better. Why do you wait? Arise and be baptized and be washed in the blood for all your sins and call on the name of the Lord. Is there anyone here? Is there anyone here? Oh, we're not going to say that New Hope is a perfect church. No church is perfect. I've been to all of them. I've been to a lot of them. I've been Pentecostal. I've been Baptist. I've dealt with the churches of God? Would you call on him right now? God is God. Oh, I wouldn't let another day, another hour pass that I have not accepted him. Guess what? He accepts you just as you are. He don't care where you come from. Have I got a witness? Oh, I listened to Reverend Greeley when he was talking and saying that God accepts us right where we are. And thank God for that. I could have been a Muslim, and that's all right. But I chose Jesus because he died for me. All the things I've been through in this world and this life, all the dirt that we've done, Nick, still God loves us. Ain't that right? Who can serve a God like that? Would you come? Would you come? He stands waiting. This is the day. This is the first day of your life. God stands waiting for you. Oh, I'm full of faults. You can look around and you'll see other men and women that are standing right next to you, sitting right next to you. We're not perfect, not in a long shot. Some of us might even cuss you out if you get on the wrong side of us. But if you talk to us about Jesus and remind us who he is and who we represent, you'll see a change. And I mean a change. I mean a change. He's playing at the cross. At the cross where I first saw the light. And the burdens of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight. I've been happy all the day. Do I have a witness? Somebody ought to stand up and give God a hand. Did you go through it? But did God see you through it? Have you walked in darkness, but did God show you the light? Somebody ought to give him some praise here today. All those that are saved, would you stand? Be a living testimony. Look around you. God touched every one of them. Every one of them are like new, happy. Those of you that are not standing, I would suggest that this is the day of your life. You're not promised tomorrow.
Church, say amen. I want to thank God for the message and thank God for the messenger. Delvin Watson came to us today. He broke it down and he kept it real. Amen. And now it's time for our announcements. We will hear from our media ministry.
Good day, New Hope. Here are your announcements for the week.
Holy Week Revival will be held April 12th through 14th at 7 p.m. here at New Hope. The speakers will feature Dr. Dennis McMurray from Renaissance Church of God in Christ and Pastor Daniel Parker with Kingdom Life Ministry. There will be a special Timbrae service, The Road to Calvary, on Friday, April 14th. Please plan to join us for this special celebration of Easter.
Family Leadership Initiative will be meeting in the multi-purpose room following morning worship. This is a great opportunity for you and your family to grow spiritually. Come join us. Dinner will be served. Attention parents of children participating in the Easter presentation will meet today in the overflow near the resource room. Children's Easter rehearsal will begin on Tuesday, March 28th at 6 p.m. in the sanctuary.
Join us on Monday nights from 7 to 9 p.m. for Pray and Play Basketball. This is a free open gym for students in grades 4 through 12. For more information, please contact Brother Quentin Henry at 616-262-4145. School will be out in 12 short weeks. Plans for Summer Blast Day Camp are already underway. Please check out our website for summer job opportunities or to enroll your child in the K through 6th grade program. The day camp will feature two nutritious meals, field trips, and educational experiences. The women of the church are invited to Sunday dinner on April 2nd from 1 to 3 p.m. in the multipurpose room. Come and share how God reveals himself and his plan in new ways. Please RSVP for this free event today in the Narthex. The divas are in the house.
The Seniors Ministry is hosting a Quality of Life workshop presented by our own Cheryl Cannon on Saturday, April 8th at 2 p.m. in the multipurpose room. Everyone age 50 and over is invited. Please plan to attend this informative workshop. Topics will include assisted living, nursing facilities, and more.
The New Hope Marriage Ministry presents Couples and Canvas, an evening of painting, relaxing, and fun for all serious, engaged, and married couples on Friday, March 31st from 7 to 9 p.m. The event will be held at Painting with a Twist. The cost is $70 per couple. If you get in early, the first 10 couples can register for $50. Please sign up after service in the Narthex or in the office. On Saturday, April 29th, Pathways to Education, Family Leadership Initiative, and Youth and Children's Ministry will present Unleash Your Talent Expo from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Youth and adults are welcome to attend. Registration starts April 2nd in the Narthex.
This concludes our announcements. Follow us on Facebook or Twitter. You can also check out our webpage at www.newhopegr.org. And if you would like a copy of today's service on DVD or CD, you can make a purchase for $5 at the media window. Have a blessed and wonderful week.
Amen, amen. Lots of activities going on. Please keep all of these in mind. Just want to highlight real quick, today's the last day to sign up for Couples in Canvas. You can do so out in the Narthex right after service. That cost is $70. All the $50 spots have been taken. Parents of children who would like to participate in the Easter service, please meet with the Drama Ministry immediately in the overflow by the resource room. And please make sure you mark your calendar for our Holy Week Revival that starts on April 12th. This is definitely going to be a blessing for us. And now, because this is the fourth Sunday, we're going to recognize our anniversaries and birthdays. All the couples that have an anniversary in the month of March, please stand up. Yep, March. Okay. Sister Forrest. Oh, you got a birthday in March. Okay. We're getting the birthdays. Anniversaries first. Deacon. Lewis and Geneva Montgomery, 52 years. All right. Lamar? Lamar and Sophia, 37 years. Our brother here? The Whitfields, 6 years. All right, 26 years in February. Amen. Okay. And if you had a birthday in March, Sister Forrest, you can go ahead and stand up along with her. Happy birthday. And now we want to feature a very special person right now. Would Aoki Merriweather come forward and bring your family with you? If you're here, Aoki Merriweather. Here she comes.
Good morning, New Hope. How do you pronounce that? Aoki? Aoki? Who are the parents? Okay, we want to present to you. Open that up for me, sir. A certificate of dedication. Today, you two have decided to dedicate your child back to the Lord.
Amen.
This is a very serious charge. God takes it very seriously. So I'll be reading to you from the minister's manual what the Lord expects of you two. I remind you that God has graciously given you this child. She belongs to you, but in a greater way, she belongs to God. I remind you of the great responsibility that is placed on you two because of the birth of this child. God has given you two the task of caring for her physical needs, clothing, food, shelter, and your love and discipline. Even more importantly, you are also charged with the responsibility of her spiritual needs. We are more than just physical. We are also spiritual. You two today are charged with the responsibility of seeing that your child is in God's house, learning about God. You must teach her to honor, love, and worship God. You are both charged with teaching this child God's holy word. You must teach her godliness, Christian moral values, and how to know God's will for her life by teaching her to love the Bible. The home was the first institution brought into existence by God. Now the church has been given by Jesus Christ. These two have been brought together to faithfully train and encourage all of us in the Lord Jesus Christ. The Church of Jesus stands nearby. New Hope stands today with you in every way that we can to help in nurturing and raising your child, to properly teach this child to live life to the fullest. It's your responsibility, and New Hope today share in that responsibility. Christ as her Lord and Savior. So, until this child reaches the age of being accountable for her own actions, she will then personally accept Christ as her Lord and Savior, just as you two have. And you have, right? Then she'll be ready for Christian baptism, which comes when they reach that age of accountability. So, church, let's embrace our new member of New Hope Baptist Church. And we're going to pray for this child. We're going to pray for this child. Let's bow our heads and have a word of prayer. Lord God, this family has decided to commit this child back to you, recognizing, Lord, that she is a gift from you. They now give her back to you, God, asking for your protection, for your guidance, for your strength. And they ask, Lord, also this morning for your continued guidance in their lives, that they might be the parents, Lord, that you intended for them to be for this child. We pray now that you would cover them with your great love. Protect them by your great power. Lead and guide and give them the direction that they need to raise this child in a world that has been broken. It is in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ that we do pray. Amen. God bless you.